Python is everywhere in data. We use it in data engineering. We use it in analytics. We use it in AI, obviously, and automation. But when it comes to data integration, most teams default to a visual canvas tool for many reasons. They're intuitive, they're collaborative, and they're fun. Although visual canvases are valuable for quickly mapping flows across teams, spotting dependencies at a glance, scaling up workflows by modifying hundreds or thousands of pipelines quickly become a challenge. So here's the question. What if you could build and modify those same pipelines entirely in Python? That's where the Python SDK comes in. A Python SDK is a software developer kit that lets you design, build, and manage data pipelines as code. By leveraging Python's flexibility, developers can programmatically create workflows while collaborating with teammates who prefer the visual tools. This approach bridges the gap between the code-first and visual-first workflows, enabling everyone to contribute to the same ecosystem. So, what makes the Python SDK so special? A Python SDK simplifies the process of creating and managing data workflows. Instead of relying on extensive configurations or manual steps, the SDK provides an intuitive interface for defining sources, transformations, and targets. Complex configuration can be reduced to just a few lines of Python code, making the SDK simple to use. We can use Python's full capabilities to define loops, conditionals, parameters, and reusable templates, making the SDK very flexible. Lastly, we can update multiple pipelines programmatically, generate new workflows dynamically, or deploy templates across teams, making the SDK scalable. In short, the SDK transforms pipeline development into fast, scalable, maintainable, code-first integration while giving you all of the power of the engine under the hood. Let's get practical. Imagine a typical ETL workflow. We're joining two data sources. Let's say a user database and a transaction database. We'll do a join, maybe on some kind of ID. Then we'll do some kind of transformation, maybe a filter. And lastly, we're going to put this into a target database. Traditionally, this might involve a GUI-based workflow. With a Python SDK, this same pipeline could be expressed as a simple Python script, one that can be versioned, tested, and deployed, just like any other code. And here's why this approach is essential for modern data workflows. Updating connection strings across 100 pipelines in a GUI could take days. With Python, a single script can make these changes in minutes. The benefit of this SDK is that we can bulk update. Common ingestion or transformation patterns can be turned into Python templates, enabling teams to spin up new workflows consistently and efficiently. We'll call this templating pipeline as code. Last, we can respond to new data sources automatically by generating pipelines programmatically based on metadata or event triggers. We'll call this dynamic pipeline creation. These are challenges that visual tools can't solve alone, but in code, they become natural, scalable, and fast. So far, we've talked about why a Python SDK matters for developers and data team. But the story doesn't stop there, because today, data integration isn't just about humans writing code. It's about AI systems and autonomous agents joining the team. And that's where things get really interesting. Large language models can do more than just chat. With the SDK, they become your teammates in your data integration projects. Say you have a flow. We'll use the example before. We have a source, maybe some basic transformations, and then to a target. Let's say you ask the LLM, hey, can we switch this PostgreSQL to S3 and maybe add a data cleansing step as well? The LLM would then generate the corresponding Python script and instantly make those changes for you. So we'll swap this out for an S3. Let's say a new developer on your team joins and asks, hey, how do I schedule a job for this flow every hour? The LLM responds not only with the Python snippet, but with a step-by-step breakdown of how exactly this SDK code works. What if your pipeline fails? Maybe at the transformation step, or maybe at the source step. The LLM can scan your logs, identify the problem, and produce the corresponding SDK code to bring your flow back up online. Beyond coding, the LLM can also become a coach. New users can ask, hey, how do I build a join between these two sources? And once again, the LLM not only writes the SDK code, but explains the reasoning and the syntax behind it. Now, so instead of being a passive Q&A tool, the LLM becomes an active and experienced pipeline engineer. And this is all made possible by the SDK. Now, let's go one step further with autonomous agents. Agents are not very effective at using GUIs. GUIs are meant for graphical human interfaces, which are very effective for us, but not very effective for agents. They need a programmatic interface, and this is where the SDK becomes their control panel. Picture an agent spinning up a new pipeline at 2 a.m. It connects to a source, applies transformations, and writes to a target all on its own. Agents can continuously create flows, execute jobs, and monitor them, all without needing the human to touch the UI. Now imagine a new teammate joins the project. The agent instantly detects it and uses the SDK to assign the right permissions. No tickets, no delays. We'll call this dynamic permissions. What if a nightly job fails? Instead of paging someone, the agent can retry the runs, scale up engines, and adjust the flow logic automatically. Recovery. And lastly, when the flow finishes, the agent can send a message to Slack, update dashboards, or chain SDK actions with external APIs to keep everything in sync. With the SDK, the agents aren't just observers. They become autonomous operators, running, fixing, and orchestrating pipelines end-to-end. So, when you think about the Python SDK, don't just think about developers writing code. Think a bigger ecosystem. Humans, LLMs, and agents all collaborating through the same interface. That is the future of data integration, and it is already here.